Your mouse is slowing you down. These Ubuntu keyboard shortcuts, they are like cheat codes for your productivity. Not only they will save your time, you will also feel like a pro user. Hey, I'm Abhishek from itswas.com, and in this video, I'll share some of my favorite keyboard shortcuts in Ubuntu that I think you should be using too. Before you see any of these shortcuts, know that I'll be referring a super key several times. This super key is likely to be the Windows key in most keyboards. Most of the shortcuts discussed here should also be applicable in other distributions with GNOME desktop. Alright, let's see some essential Ubuntu keyboard shortcuts to make you a ninja Linux user. You already know that pressing the super key will bring up the activity area showing opened applications and allowing you to search for applications. But if you press super and A, it shows the installed applications in a grid view. Now that's something, right? And if you press super plus D, it will minimize all the running application windows and show you the desktop. By the way, it only works in Ubuntu and not in vanilla GNOME. Pressing the super plus L will lock the screen. This is my favorite way of quickly locking the computer when I'm moving away from my desk. Press super and M together and it opens the message tray. This is handy for quickly accessing the notifications. If you have more than one keyboard inputs enabled, you can quickly switch between them with super and space. A godsend for my European friends here, right? And here comes another of my favorite that not many people know of. If you press super plus a number between 1 to 9, it will open the application on that position in the launcher. On any Linux system I use, I always keep the first few apps in the same order. 2 for Firefox Explorer, 3rd for my primary browser, 4 for Discord, and 5 for Spotify, and so on. Now don't ask me what is the application at number 1 because I don't remember why and how I got into the habit of arranging the few of my frequently used apps from second position. Seems like my array starts at 2. Before we move further, let me thank our sponsor.
AnyRun provides interactive malware analysis and threat intelligence services trusted by over 500,000 security professionals worldwide. With real-time interactivity, AnyRun's sandbox lets you safely analyze and engage with threats as if they were on your own computer. Plus, AnyRun's threat intelligence lookup helps you find specific threats and enrich existing indicators by searching a vast database.
Pressing Ctrl Q will close an active application window, except for the terminal. This is equivalent to the Alt F4 combination from a certain operating system that you know which one it is. Anyways, Ctrl Alt plus arrow key will help you move between workspaces. Smooth. Ctrl Alt plus T will open the default terminal emulator in Ubuntu, and this is very Ubuntu specific shortcut. Ctrl Alt delete will bring up, no, it's not task manager. It will simply log you out of the current session. You are not in Windows anymore, my friend. The task manager, aka system monitor, should be accessed from the menu, not using the Ctrl Alt tell. Enough of Ctrl. Let's move to alternative. That is the Alt key. If you press Alt plus F2, GNOME opens a dialog box to run commands. While you can use it to run a few commands of your choice, I mostly use it when I have to refresh the GNOME shell by entering R. It helps while dealing with some extension that changes the behavior of the GNOME shell and it needs to be reloaded. You can use Alt plus Tab and it will open up this app switcher, allowing you to switch between the running applications easily. You can also use super plus tab for this purpose, which probably won't show you the preview of the running applications. You didn't notice, did you? For both methods, if you use shift plus tab along with alt or super keys, it will allow you to move in the reverse direction. This way you won't have to cycle through all the applications to come back to the desired one if you skipped it earlier. If you have more than one instances of the same applications running, you can cycle through them by pressing the down arrow key or the back tick key. Don't forget that you can also create your own custom shortcut keys. For example, I have this 10-less mechanical keyboard that doesn't have the print screen key. So I have set up the print screen function with the Alt P keys. These were the most common keyboard shortcuts I use in Ubuntu. and I'm guessing you probably already knew a few of them. Did you learn some new keyboard shortcuts that you are going to use? The comment section is all yours. Stay subscribed and I'll see you with more helpful Linux videos. See ya, bye.